Good afternoon, friends. Today our topic is pedogenic processes. So first time, according to Simonson, 1959, there are four basic pedogenic processes. First one is additions or gains. Second one is losses. Third one is transformation. And fourth one is translocation. So these are the basic pedogenic processes according to Simonson. So in additions or gains, we can say example addition of water mostly as rainfall. And second example for the additions is addition of organic matter. Coming to the losses, in losses we can say different examples like loss of nutrients from the soil by leaching process. That is one of the example for the losses. And second example for the losses is loss of organic matter by microbial decomposition. These two are the examples for the losses. And coming to the transformation. So when the soil material, different soil material modified physically or chemically, and if they synthesize or if they form different new materials from the precursor material, is known as transformation. Coming to the example for the transformation, weathering of primary minerals results in the formation of different clay minerals. That is the example for the transformation. Coming to the fourth one, translocation. Translocation is nothing but movement of soil material from one place to another place within the soil is known as translocation. And this translocation is two types. First one is in the soil solution. So if the translocation occurs in the soil solution, which is known as leaching. And second one is in soil suspension. So this is known as elevation. So these are the different basic pedogenic processes according to Simonson, 1959. Additions are gains, losses, transformation and translocation. Now I am going to discuss about fundamental pedogenic process. Now I am going to discuss about fundamental pedogenic process. So fundamental pedogenic process are three types. So first one is humification, and second one is elevation. This is also known as emigration. And third one is elevation. So remember, fundamental pedogenic process are three types: humification, elevation, this is also known as emigration. Third one is elevation, this is also known as immigration. Immigration. Coming to the first one, humification. So humification is nothing but conversion of raw organic matter into humus. So conversion of organic matter into humus, that is known as humification. Suppose when we add different organic materials to the soil, so they can be attacked by the different microbes like fungi, bacteria and actinomyces. So after attacking by the different microbes, they can be converted into simple organic acids. So further, by bacterial polymerization, these organic acids are produced dark brown color substance, that is known as humus. Remember, after formation of humus, that is highly resistant to microbial attack. So this is about humification. Humification is nothing but conversion of organic matter into humus is known as humification. So when we add different organic residues to the soil, they can be attacked by the different microbes like bacteria, fungi and actinomyces. So they can produce different simple organic acids, and these organic acids further by bacterial polymerization produce dark brown substance that is known as humus, which is highly resistant to microbial attack. And for completion of humification process, at least 10 years, it will take 10 years. That means near a decade, which means a decade. And coming to the elevation, elevation also known as emigration. Elevation is nothing but here, E means exit. Remember, here E means exit. That means loss of clay and iron oxides from the e-origin of the soil profile is known as elevation. And especially elevation occur in the e-origin of soil profile, sometimes e-origin also known as A2-origin. So this is about elevation. This is also known as emigration. And coming to the elevation, here I means inside. Here I means inside. That means accumulation or deposition of clay and iron oxides in the B-origin, especially BT-origin of the soil profile, is known as elevation. Elevation also known as immigration. So this is about fundamental pedogenic process. Now I am going to discuss about specific pedogenic process. Coming to the specific pedogenic process. This specific pedogenic process two types. First one is zonal and second one is intrazonal. In zonal, first one is calcification, second one is decalcification, third one is parcelization, and fourth one is lateralization. So these four comes under zonal pedogenic process. And coming to the intrazonal, in this first one is serenization and second one is soronization. This is also known as alkalization. And third one is dealkalization. And last one is glaciation. So this is about specific pedogenic process. And remember, the difference between the zonal specific pedogenic process and intrazonal is the zonal specific pedogenic processes are mainly influenced by climate and biosphere. These two are active soil forming factors. And coming to intrazonal specific pedogenic process, these are influenced by mainly local conditions like parent material, second one is relief or topography. So here the difference is zonal specific pedogenic processes are mainly influenced by active soil forming factors like climate and biosphere. Coming to intrazonal, these are influenced by passive soil forming factors like parent material and relief. Now I am going to discuss about calcification. Coming to calcification. So remember, the name itself saying that calcification is nothing but accumulation of calcium ions or calcium carbonate is known as calcification. And remember, this calcification mainly occurs in the arid and semi-arid regions. Arid and semi-arid climatic conditions. And this calcification process leads to the formation of calcic origin. That is known as calcic origin. And if you see the depth of the calcic origin in the arid climatic condition, it is less than 50 centimeter. And coming to semi-arid 50 to 150 cm and coming to humid. In humid climatic condition, the depth of the calcium hydrogen is greater than 150 cm. This is about calcification. And if you see the reaction for the calcification process, CO2 plus H2O, that is H2CO3, and H2CO3 combines with the calcium and which forms calcium bicarbonate, which is soluble. And calcium bicarbonate gives rise to beer, more temperature and less carbon dioxide gives calcium carbonate CO2 plus H2O. This is about calcification. Calcification is nothing but precipitation and accumulation of calcium ions or calcium carbonate in the some part of soil profile. This is known as calcification. Calcification mainly occurs in the arid and semi-arid climatic conditions, and this calcification process leads to the formation of calcic hydrogen. And if you see the depth of calcic hydrogen in the arid climatic condition, which is less than 50 cm, coming to semi-arid 50 to 150 cm, and coming to humid greater than 150 cm. And the reaction is CO2 plus H2O, carbonic acid, that is H2CO3. H2CO3 when combines with the calcium, which gives calcium bicarbonate, which is highly soluble. And this is the final reaction. Here temperature is high and carbon dioxide is less. And coming to second specific pyrogenic process comes under the journal is degasification. Remember, degasification is nothing but D means removal. That means removal of calcium carbonate from the soil is known as degasification. So that means the degasification is exact opposite of calcification. In previous class, we have discussed about calcification and degasification. Calcification is nothing but accumulation of calcium ions or calcium carbonate in the some part of the soil profile is known as calcification, and which is occurring in the arid and semi-arid climatic conditions, and which leads to formation of calcic hydrogen. And if you see the depth of calcic hydrogen in the arid climatic condition, which is less than 50 cm, coming to semi-arid 50 to 150 cm, and subhumid or humid greater than 150 cm. And second one is decalcification. Decalcification is nothing but removal of calcium carbonate from the soil or soil solution by leaching process is known as decalcification. And decalcification is exact opposite of calcification, and decalcification occur in the humid climatic condition instead of arid and semi-arid climatic conditions. Now I am going to discuss about third specific zonal pyrogenic process, that is podzolization. And fourth one is lateralization. So if you see the Russian language, so that is pod means under and zola means ash-like. Okay, and coming to the definition of podzolization, what is podzolization? Podzolization is nothing but accumulation of silica and removal of cesspi oxides. Cesspi oxides are nothing but oxides of iron and aluminum. And coming to the, this is about definition, and coming to the climatic condition for the podzolization is cool humid. We can say cold and humid climatic condition. And if you see the parent material for the podzolization process is siliceous. So we can say sandy parent material. And for the pH for the podzolization process is less than 5.0. And the vegetation, if we see the vegetation for the podzolization process is coniferous. So we can say narrow leaf. And if you see the dominant organism in podzolization process is fungi. Remember, this podzolization also known as acid hydrolysis. This is one of the very, very important bit. So remember here, due to high rainfall in the pasteurization process, there is intensive leaching of calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium. These four are known as basic salts. That means due to high rainfall, and remember, with high rainfall there is another chance, sandy parent material. So due to sandy parent material and high rainfall, there is intensive leaching of basic salts like calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium in the pasteurization. That's why if you see the pH of the pasteurization process is less than 5. Why? Because here intensive leaching of basic salts are there. That means there is no chance for the basic salts in the pasteurization process. And another reason for the pH less than 5 here, if you see the vegetation for the pasteurization, that is coniferous, that means acid producing vegetation. So due to these two reasons, the pH of the pasteurization process is less than 5. And here, as a science student, you should know why only silica accumulate in here, why not cesspit acids. The definition of pasteurization is accumulation of silica and removal of cesspit acids. Remember, when the pH of the soil is less than 5 due to some reasons, so the silica is highly insoluble. When the pH is less, that means when the pH is less than 5, the silica is highly insoluble. That's why which remains in the surface. That means there is accumulation of silica. And in this pH, there is solubility of iron, aluminium occur. That means this iron and aluminium is highly soluble at this pH, but not silica. That's why due to less pH in the pasteurization process, silica is accumulating and there is leaching of iron and aluminium oxides. This is about pasteurization. And coming to the lacquerization. Lacquer means brick or tile. Lacquer means brick or tile. So here, pasteurization is nothing but accumulation of silica and removal of cesspit oxides. Coming to the lacquerization, lacquerization is nothing but accumulation of cesspit oxides and removal of silica. Accumulation of cesspit oxides and removal of silica is known as lacquerization. And if you see the climatic condition for the lacquerization process, instead of cold humid, here warm humid. And coming to the parent material for the lacquerization process, basic parent material. Here in pasteurization, siliceous, sandy or coarse parent material. Here, basic parent material. And coming to the pH of the lacquerization process, near neutral. And if you see the vegetation in lacquerization, broadleaf. And coming to the dominant organism in the lacquerization process, bacteria. But here remember, although there is intensive leaching of basic salts in the lacquerization process, the pH of the lacquerization process is neutral. Why? Because it is just because of the basic nature of parent material. Just because of basic nature of parent material and vegetation, broadleaf. Due to these two reasons, the pH of the lacquerization process is neutral. Although there is intensive leaching of basic salts like calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium. So this is about complete pasteurization and lacquerization. And lacquerization also known as alkali hydrolysis. Alkali hydrolysis. So this is about complete pasteurization and lacquerization. Now I am going to discuss about intrazonal specific pedogenic process. Now I am going to discuss about intrazonal specific pedogenic process. So in intrazonal, first one is salinization. So remember, salinization is nothing but accumulation of chlorides and sulfates of calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium in the soil solution is known as salinization. That means accumulation of salts. These salts, especially chlorides and sulfates of calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium. That means accumulation of salts of chlorides and sulfates of calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium in the soil is known as salinization. And due to salinization process, saline salts will be formed. Saline salts will be formed, and the saline salts also known as soran chalks and also known as white alkaline soils. Remember, in saline soils there is more number of neutral salts. Neutral salts are nothing but chlorides and sulfates of calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium as compared to carbonates and bicarbonates of sodium. That means the concentration of carbonates and bicarbonates of sodium in saline soils is very less as compared to neutral salts. And if you see the pH of saline soils, it is less than 8.5. And due to more number of neutral salts, if you see the electrical conductivity of the saline soil, it is greater than 4 decisiemens per meter. And coming to the exchangeable sodium percentage of saline soil, it is less than 15. And coming to sodium adsorption ratio, it is less than 13. But remember, in saline soils, the dominant cation is calcium, which is highly responsible for the flocculation. That's why the physical condition of the saline soils due to high concentration of the neutral salts or calcium is flocculated. And the last one is, if you see the salt concentration in the saline soil, that is greater than 0.1%. And last point regarding saline soils, we can manage or we can reclaim the saline soils by leaching process. This is about complete salinization. And coming to alkalization, next one is alkalization. Alkalization also known as soranization. Next one is alkalization. Alkalization also known as soranization. So the definition of alkalization is nothing but it is accumulation of sodium in the soil profile or on exchangeable complex is known as alkalization. So due to soranization or alkalization, sodic salts will be formed. So the sodic salts, other name for the sodic salts is soranage and black alkali. So remember, in sodic soils there is more number of carbonates and bicarbonates of sodium as compared to neutral salts. That's why the dominant cation in the sodic soils is sodium. And remember, the pH of the sodic soils is greater than 8.5. Why? Because here the dominant cation is sodium, and the sodium involves in the hydrolysis process and which liberates hydroxyl ions or OH minus ions. Once soil solution gets more number of OH minus ions, definitely there will be more pH. That's why the pH of the sodic soils or alkali soils attains up to 10 to 11 pH sometimes. And another reason for the high pH in sodic soils, remember, sodium carbonate is more soluble or 100 times more soluble as compared to calcium carbonate and magnesium carbonate. Due to this reason, which maintains more number of carbonates and bicarbonate ions in the solution. One soil solution having more number of carbonate ions and bicarbonate ions, definitely there will be more pH. That's why the pH of the sodic soil is greater than 8.5. And coming to exchangeable sodium percentage in sodic soils is greater than 15, and sodium adsorption ratio is greater than 13. Due to less number of salts or neutral salts, the EC of the sodic soil is less than 4 decisiemens per meter. And why we are calling sodic soils as black alkali soils? Due to high pH, here accumulation or dispersion of sodium with the humus can be occur. That means here organic matter or humus accumulating on the surface due to high pH. That's why we can say sodic soils black alkali soils. But coming to saline soils also known as white alkali soils. Why? Because due to evaporation process in the arid and semi-arid climatic conditions, there will be accumulation of salts on the surface soil, which gives white encrustation. That's why saline soils also known as white alkali soils. Coming to sodic soils, blood organelles. This is about salinization and alkalization. Coming to another intracellular specific pathogenic process, that is solo digestion or dealkalization. Dealkalization is nothing but removal of sodium from the extensible complex is known as dealkalization. This alkalization occurs in the arid and semi-arid climatic condition, but coming to dealkalization here, that means removal of sodium. So this dealkalization occurs in the humid climatic condition. And last specific intracellular pathogenic process is glaciation. So last one is glaciation. So this is Russian term. Glay means blue or green or gray. So gray color, clay. That means glaciation is nothing but development of blue color or green color or gray color horizon in the soil profile is known as glaciation. And remember, this glaciation process occurs in the waterlogged condition. Waterlogged conditions. That's why the soils which are forming due to the glaciation process are known as hydromorphic soils. So this is about glaciation. And there is another pathogenic process or specific pathogenic process, that is peridotation. Peridotation is nothing but mixing of soils. Mixing of soils. So this is three types. First one is floral, and second one is faunal, and last one is argillary. So if the mixing of soils occur due to plants, that is known as floral peridotation. If the mixing of soils occur due to animals like ants, rodents and earthworms, that is known as faunal peridotation. And coming to argillary peridotation. Argillary peridotation is nothing but if the mixing of soils occur due to churning process in swelling and shrinkage soils, that is vertisols, that is known as argillary peridotation. This is complete specific zonal and intrazonal pathogenic process. Thank you.